When the vocal falls flat, the whole song falls flat. Hey, my name is Brian, and I'm gonna give you 5 easy delay tips to make your vocal sound polished and larger than life in any mix. So it's important to make sure that the vocal really stands out and grabs the attention of the listener. So the first trick is to use a super short slap delay to make the vocal feel bigger and wider. The song I'm gonna use today is called Undertow by my band Eastern Souvenirs. And I'm just gonna play a short snippet of the song to give you some context. The vocal has some EQ, compression, and saturation, but no delay or reverb yet. Something is pulling you backwards. Something is holding you down. So to set up this effect, I'm going to send the main vocal to a bus. I already have it set up here, and add a tape delay plugin. I like using tape delay because it naturally has some saturation and some modulation to it, which sounds good for this effect. I'm using the J37 plugin from Waves, which has some saturation and built-in tape delay features, and I think it sounds great for this, but you can use whichever tape plugin you like. So the first thing you do is set the feedback to 0 or put it in slap mode. Next, you want to adjust the timing. And for this, I set the right channel to 40 milliseconds and the left channel to 55 milliseconds. You can play around with the timing depending on what you like, but I wouldn't go any longer than 60 milliseconds because then it starts sounding more obviously like a delay and we're kind of after more of a stereo widening effect. The next thing you want to do is filter off all of the low end below 250 Hertz with a high pass filter and filter off everything above 8,000 Hertz with a low pass filter. If you don't have one built in, you can just add an EQ afterwards on the bus. So I'm going to go ahead and play back the vocal in solo and then slowly bring this up until you can start to feel the vocal spread out. This should be a fairly subtle effect. Something is pulling you backwards, and something is holding you down. Perfect. So you want this to be felt more than heard. Just go about to where you can really hear the effects start to pop out and dial it back a little bit. So here's a quick A-B with and without the slap. Something is pulling you backwards. Something is pulling you backwards. So it's a very subtle effect, but the goal is to really help the vocal pop out a little bit and just feel a little bigger and wider in the track. Okay, so trick number 2 is to use another slap delay that's a little bit longer to sit the vocal in the mix while still keeping it dry and up front. This is really helpful, especially in pop tracks where you don't want to use a lot of reverb. Sometimes when it's just completely dry, it just doesn't feel like it's meshing. It doesn't feel like it's in a realistic acoustic space. And so this can really solve that problem. So I sent the main vocal to a bus and I used Echo Boy this time. Typically for this kind of slap delay, I'll use a 16th note division. If you use note divisions, it helps blend into the track more seamlessly. But if you want the slap delay to stand out a little bit more, then you can offset it so it's not falling on an exact beat division. Anywhere between 80 milliseconds to 180 milliseconds is usually a good range for slap delay. Again, you want to keep the feedback at 0, so we're getting 1 repeat. The next thing you want to do, either with an EQ or if it's built into your plugin, is to roll off some low end and some high end. So usually somewhere around 250 Hertz, maybe even 350. And then for the high end, rolling it off 4K, even as low as 2K sometimes. You can really play around with this to get a darker or brighter slapback, just depending on what you like. And then add a little bit of saturation. That can be a cool effect as well. And then the last thing I did was add a little bit of stereo width. So again, you can use the left-right offset or manually change the timings of the left and right channel so you get a little bit more of a stereo image from the delay. All right, so now that we have it set up, I'm gonna play back the vocal in solo so you can really hear the effect and what it sounds like. Something is pulling you backwards. All right, so I'm gonna play it back in the context of the mix, and I'll start with the slap delay muted and then bring it in halfway through so you can hear how it sits the vocal into the mix.
Something is pulling you backwards. And something is holding you down.
So this can be a very subtle effect that just helps the vocal to blend more with the mix, or you can have it be a really audible effect if you want more of a retro slapback sound. Okay, so the third trick is to use ping pong delay to add depth and dimension to a vocal without pushing it too far back in the mix. A lot of times when you add longer reverbs, they can sound awesome in solo, but can really clutter up a mix. So this is a good compromise that can add a sense of space and dimension without creating all of that mud. So to set this up, you're gonna send your vocal to a bus like we did before. Here I added Echo Boy. You can use whatever delay plugin you have. Set it to ping pong mode. So that basically means the echo is gonna feed back from left to right and kind of bounce back and forth between those channels. And set it to an eighth note division. I like to use eighth note divisions. You can try quarter note as well, but sometimes depending on the tempo of the song, it can sound a bit distracting. Set your feedback to around 40 or 50%. And then again, we're gonna roll off some low end and some high end. You can be a little bit more aggressive with this. Maybe roll off everything below 400 hertz and everything above 3 kilohertz. For this, I actually did add another EQ and did that very move. I actually rolled off everything above 4K and then everything below 400. And so that kind of helps it to not distract you from the lead vocal, just kind of keep it focused more in the mid-range. I also added a little bit of saturation, which can be a nice effect as well. Just to give it a little bit of a different texture from the lead vocal. Okay, so I'm gonna play this back in solo with the ping pong delay so you can hear how that sounds.
Something is pulling you backwards.
All right, once you have that set up, bring up the volume of the ping pong delay in the context of the mix until it starts to sound a little bit obvious in the mix, and then pull it down. You really want this to be an effect that adds space to the vocal without sounding overly obvious and kind of in your face. So here's how it sounds in the context of the mix. I'll play it back without the ping pong delay and then with.
Something is pulling you backwards. Something is pulling you backwards. Something is holding you down.
So you'll notice it's very subtle when it's in the context of the track, but when I solo the vocal, it becomes super obvious. And that's by design. I want this to add space to the vocal, but I don't want it to be a super in-your-face effect that distracts you from the lead vocal performance. All right, the fourth trick is to use a duct long delay when you want to hear the delay tail, but you don't want it to mask the vocal. Okay, so for this song, I wanna go for maybe a more psychedelic vocal delay effect where you can hear audible repeats of the vocal. So I sent it to a bus and I added an eighth note delay with Echo Boy. I chose the space echo style, added a little bit of saturation for character, and dialed in quite a bit of feedback. So right out of the gate, this is how it sounds.
Something is pulling you backwards.
So that sounds great to me, but what I wanna do next is kind of roll off a little bit more of the low end and high end. Again, everything below 400 hertz is rolled off and above 4K. So here's how that sounds.
Something is pulling you backwards.
So it makes it a little bit more mid-range focused so that it sits behind the lead vocal more, but I'm still finding that it's cluttering the lead vocal. So what I can do next is bring up a compressor and sidechain it to the main vocal. So here I chose main vocals
and I have it set at about an 8-to-1 ratio, very fast attack, and release somewhere between 200 to 300 milliseconds is a good bet, or you can go auto. Just kind of experiment with what you like, and no makeup gain. And then I set my threshold so that I'm getting around 6 to 8 dB of compression. And what this does is when the lead vocal is playing, the dry signal is going to turn down the delay. And then as soon as I finish singing, the delay tail is going to bloom and sort of come up. And so the release setting becomes really important because you want to control how quickly that volume gets turned up on the effect. So you'll want to play this back in context and play around with the release until it sounds natural. So here's how that sounds with the sidechained compression.
Something is pulling you backwards.
So yeah, much more intelligibility with the vocal. Here's how it sounds in context.
Something is pulling you backwards. And something is holding you down.
And there you go, you can get some awesome psychedelic vocal delay effects without completely ruining the intelligibility of your vocal. So the fifth trick is a classic delay throw. And this is used to add emphasis or interest to a vocal performance. You basically send specific words or phrases to a longer delay. And there's two different main ways to set this up. The first is to set up a bus with a delay on it and to automate certain words to send to that delay. The second way is to actually duplicate the vocal track and delete all of the audio except for the specific words that you want to trigger the delay. So for this song, I did the former, and I created a bus with a delay throw on it, and I automated certain words to send to that. So I automated the end of this phrase.
It's holding you down.
So down.
Think you might drown.
And drown. So both those words will send to the delay. Now let's go to the bus and see what I did there. So the way that you set this up, grab a delay plugin of your choice. In this case, again, I'm using Echo Boy, super versatile. Use Space Echo, added a little bit of saturation to taste. And the first thing that you want to look at is the beat division. So usually quarter notes or half notes work well, but it can be fun to play around with triplets and dotted notes as well. So for this, I actually use a dotted quarter note, and I liked the way that that played with the rhythm of the track. The next thing you want to do is dial in some feedback. Sometimes it's nice just to have a single repeat, especially if you're repeating a small phrase, not just a single word. But in this case, I wanted kind of a trailing off delay on that last word, so I added a little bit of feedback. And this is how that sounds so far.
It's holding you down.
So the next thing I did was, again, cut out some low end and some high end, really focus on the mid range. This is to kind of make the echoes a little bit less ear catching. You know, when they have less high end and low end and are more mid range focused, they blend better into the track.
It's holding you down.
It also kind of gives it a cool, like, telephone-like filter effect. And the next thing that I did is add a bit of modulation. So I find this can be really cool for delay throws, just to, again, add an interesting texture and make it sound different from the lead vocal. So I used Micro Shift, which is a really powerful plugin for creating stereo width and modulation effects. So I chose Style 1 and played around with the detuning and the delay, and about 50% blend. And here's what I arrived at.
It's holding you down.
So yeah, super cool effect. And then the last thing that I did was send this to some reverb. So I haven't had the reverbs turned on because we've been focusing on delay. But in this track, I also have a spring reverb and a chamber going. And so I want this delay throw to feel like it's in the same sonic world as the lead vocal. So I went ahead and sent the delay to the same reverbs. So here's how that sounds.
It's holding you down.
And here's how it all sounds in the context of the track. Something is holding you down. And here's the other one. You think you might drown. So there you go, that is the delay throw. Now these settings worked great for my track, but don't feel like you need to copy them. There's a lot of ways to play around with this effect. Like I mentioned, with timing, feedback, with modulation, EQ. So experiment and see what works best for your production that you're working on. Thank you so much for watching. I hope these tips help you level up your vocal production game. And as always, be sure to like the video and subscribe to the channel to stay tuned for more content like this.